Dr. Mochly-Rosen, thanks so much for being here with me today. Tell me a little bit about the exciting work you're doing.
Well, I guess I will talk about my work in Spark. So Spark is a program we started 9 years ago with a goal to advance early discoveries in academia, clinical or basic research, to a stage where it's tested either in companies or at Stanford for the use of in patients to improve human health.
So is the point of this to kind of sort of shepherd these projects along so they don't get stuck in the lab?
Yeah, that's exactly it. Oftentimes basic research is published even in, you know, top tier journals, not picked up by industry because it's deemed to be too early, missing elements that are more familiar for industry to decide to invest long term in the development. And so this gap between those discoveries to actually impacting patient health was termed, the valley of death. We tried to stick Spark in the middle to help it. And it was my own experience that as a basic researcher that made me start to think about a program like that that will benefit others.
Do you have any projects that your organization has helped shepherd sort of toward clinical implementation that are really kind of dear to your heart or you think have been the most impactful?
Well, I think that, they're all dear to my heart. This is choosing between your children, so to speak. This is a project that was ran by a dermatologist called Alain. And Al was called into consultation for a child who had a lymph malformation, and as a result of that, actually suffered from heart failure. Mm. And she was put on sildenafil in an attempt to kind of, she had pulmonary hypertension and heart failure, in an attempt to help her heart. But he was called in because she had this huge mass on the side of her body that causing the pressure on her lung and heart. And being a dermatologist, he was called in more frequently and noted that actually once a child was put on sildenafil, which is Viagra, as you know, anti-erectile dysfunction drug, at a small dose, he noticed that this mass is shrinking and becomes very soft and easy to push against. And it was striking effect, and he was very interested to see whether it can affect other children with this problem. But from our perspective, it was a perfect example of what Spark can do, and that is to ensure that proper clinical trial is done with this compound. A paper is going to be written, and then you change clinical practice. This is a repurposing of a known drug with known effects now in a new clinical indication. So we helped him set up the clinical trial, conduct the clinical trial at Stanford. I think he treated a total of 10 children, published it in New England Journal of Medicine.
It's amazing. You're making sure some really important research doesn't essentially go unused in some ways.
Yeah, that's right. Basic research, even when published in first-rate journals, cannot move forward without further shepherding. And this work needs to be done with experts from industry. We in academia are really clueless about what is needed to kind of make the project attractive for industry.
You're right. That seems like really important work and almost an incubator to help people develop their ideas. Thank you so much for speaking with me today.
Of course.
It's great to meet you.